another recent exam problem asking what happens if you have an isothermal compression, what happens to the Gibbs free energy of a non-ideal gas. And so we can use a simple relation for the Gibbs free energy, which says that the Gibbs free energy is equal to VdP minus SdT. If we have an isothermal system, then dT is equal to zero. Therefore, dG will just be equal to VdP at constant temperature. All right, and so what this basically says is that because there's a positive correlation here, the volume is always going to be a positive number, that if the change in pressure is positive, which it is in this problem, then the change in Gibbs free energy will also be positive. All right, and so the Gibbs free energy will therefore increase. This makes sense intuitively that the Gibbs free energy we end up relating to the chemical potential of the system. And as the pressure is increased at constant temperature, we increase the chemical potential, so the likelihood that that mass will be transferred from the system is higher when that system is under high pressure.